Hey, what's up guys, NixB1HD here, and welcome back to another episode of my F1 2020 Classic Championship mode. And into episode number 2 today, and in today's episode we have got the Dutch Grand Prix around circuit Zandvoort. So before we get into qualifying, make sure you guys drop a like on the video if you are enjoying this series. Make sure you subscribe for more, and let's get into qualifying here around circuit Zandvoort. Here we go. Right, okay, here we are then, qualifying day here around circuit Zandvoort. So let's jump in, let's get into it, and let's jump back in and drive this classic 1992 Williams FW14B car. Let's get into qualifying. Here we go. Oh man, how I've missed that sound. Man, these old Formula One cars, man. You just can't beat it. P2 on the grid for the Dutch Grand Prix. We'll take that. So there we go then. Michael Eske in the 1998 McLaren MP413. He does take pole position. We're starting in P2. Calabresi in P2. And Ruben Merry, our teammate, he's starting in P4. So let's get into race day here for the Dutch Grand Prix. Here we go.
It looks like it could be a tense round of the championship here as we prepare to get today's race underway. ...2.6 miles then make up a lap here at a wet Zandvoort circuit, where some tricky braking zones and sudden drops can make it all too easy to slide off into the gravel. There are 14 corners overall and a 678 meter main straight, providing the best chance for overtaking.
Right, okay, here we are then, ready for the race here around circuit Zandvoort. We're starting in P2, so let's get into it and let's see how we get on. Here we go, 18 laps ahead of us, let's get into it. Out, away we go. Not a particularly great start. We're gonna force our way past the two McLarens. We do get a warning for a collision there with Michaleski, but we will take the lead off the race. I think if we are gonna pit, we will put on a fresh set of full wet tyres. Yeah, we'd absolutely love to get a race win with this car. That would be absolutely amazing. Oh, come on. Okay, we've got yellow flags out already.
All right, we're looking good so far.
fastest lap for us. Really got to fight to keep this car while on track. So the rain is getting lighter, which is good. Not a fastest lap, which is good. If I did have to pit, I would probably put on a brand new set of full wet tyres, but my aim is to try and not pit. Yeah, we had a really good qualifying. Hopefully we can transfer that into the race today. Thank you.
fuel target is +1. Faster engine modes are available.
Okay, copy. Lights out. Okay, Moreno is out. Thank you.
an incident in the next part of the track, no overtaking through the yellow flags.
So there is Moreno's car. Back to green flag racing. So if I did have to pit again, I would probably put on a brand new set of the wet tyres.
10 minutes left of this rain, then we think it's going to dry up. 10 minutes. Some information on Waldmüller. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car.
So Waldmüller, currently in P4, he's got some kind of issue with his car. So we've got 10 minutes until the rain is going to be drying up, but unless the team recommend a new strategy on the MFD, we are going to be taking the set of full wet tyres we've got on the car, we are going to be taking them to the end of the race. So our teammate, Ruben, he's gone up into P4, Ruben Meyer.
So far.
So, just put in the fastest lap, which is good. Trying to close up to the Jordan. And we are going to get past him. So that's one of the back marker cars navigated. I could get away with pitting and I would still come out into the lead of the race.
Okay, could be a risk with the circuit this greasy, but we think the slick might now be the quicker tyre. If you think you can keep it on the road, let's consider swapping over.
Okay, so the team reckon it is time for slick tyres. I'm not so sure. I think the track is still too wet. To lap 11 now. Thank you. so we're going to get past the McLaren. I am actually very, very tempted to put on a new set of wets, so I'm actually going to do that. Second pit stop isn't too bad.
Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track.
Okay, so these tyres should easily make it to the checkered flag. So my plan is to take these fresh wet tyres to the end of the race. I know I said I wouldn't pit, but yeah, there was quite a bit of wear on the wet tyres that we started off with, and I thought it is definitely not time for dry. So just put on a fresh set of wet tyres and that will take us to the checkered flag. However, we have got a few of the back markers to get past once again, but it is what it is. But we're still 18 seconds ahead. We are 19 seconds ahead of Michaleski, which is good. Okay, so we've got the McLaren to get past. So that's one back marker navigated for another one. Okay, the other Jordan does get out the way, which is good. So we've got the I think that's the other McLaren, and is indeed. Oh dear. Okay, so he is gonna get out of the way a bit earlier this time.
Expected to ease up in the next few minutes.
Okay. Break. It's done. Is that for us?
We have 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Okay, 5 more laps of fuel left in the car, so we should easily make it. Excuse me, should easily have enough fuel to get to the end of the race.
First position, front of the pack, Michaleski behind. Okay, the gap behind is 24.1 seconds. Look after these tyres now.
Okay, we are going to get past this Ferrari.
5 laps till the end.
Okay, how much fuel have we got?
There's four laps of fuel remaining.
So we might not be a little bit so we've done run out of fuel. Navigated. So lap 15 now. The Grand Prix, four more laps to go.
A few remaining. There's three laps of fuel remaining.
On to lap 16. Three more laps to go. It's going to be very, very close on fuel. Glad I didn't put on any dry tyres. So we've got some more back marker cars to get past. To the penultimate lap of the race. So we are going to get past the Benetton, and I think it might have been another McLaren. Yep, it was a McLaren. Thought it was mine. Just had a bit of doubt in my mind there. Brake. It's done. Okay. cars that are going to be lapped. More lap traffic to get through.
There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
Right, cool.
More than one. This lap, please. We need to get your new tyres and move on to a different strategy. This is your final lap. Final lap of the race.
We did clip the wall there, which wasn't ideal. Williams does jump out the way. Okay, round we go. Larson. Ahead of us. Okay. Okay, rounding the final corner, and we are going to take home the race victory here around Circuit Zandvoort. Get in there. What a result.
You've really been great today.
Our first win in the 1992 Williams FW14B car. Good result. And we pick up driver of the day as well.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One.
So there we go then, the end of the race, we do take home the win. Michaleski comes through for P2 and Calabresi comes through for P3. Our teammate coming through for P4, Forrest in P5, Larson in P6, Neves in Larson rounding out the points finishers. And it was just Moreno who did not make it to the checker flag. So. Looking at the championship, we are level on points with Michaleski. Forrest goes up to 6th, Neves drops down to 7th, Benjamin drops down to 8th, Weidmuller, he goes up to 9th, Moreno drops down to 10th, Giles down in 11th, Jonas in 12th, Naroy in 13th, and Kufman in 14th. So these guys all yet to score points. But that is going to be the end of this episode. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed episode 2 of the F1 2020 Classic Championship mode in the 1992 Williams FW14B car. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this episode. And if you guys have, make sure you guys drop a like on the video if you have enjoyed it. Make sure you subscribe for more. And I will see you guys for episode number 3 very soon.